What makes something science? The empirical method. That involves observation. But not all observations are scientific, even though all scientific explanations must involve observations. We've got to be systematic in our observations. Now, let's look at an example. There is a superstition that having a black cat cross your path will cause you to have a bad day. Now, if we look hard enough, I'm sure we can find an example of a person who had a black cat cross his path, and that very day, that person had some very bad happenings. Well, can we find another example? We probably can. Can we find yet another example? We probably can. Now, some politicians are fond of saying that one example is an anomaly, two is a coincidence, but three is a trend. Well, I must disagree with those politicians. That's not how we establish a trend, at least not scientifically. I'm sure if we looked hard enough, we could probably find hundreds of examples of people who had a black cat cross their path, and on that very day had something very unfortunate happen. Having hundreds of examples fit this is not a trend. It's not a trend because it does not look at the data systematically, scientifically. Now, one way to systematically examine data is to do a carefully controlled experiment where we manipulate an independent variable and then measure that dependent variable. That's one way to do it, but that's not the criterion for science, because certain sciences, like astronomy and economics, for example, really cannot rely upon experimentation. They have to use other forms of carefully controlled, systematic observations. And one of the things that they can do with those systematic observations is to at least establish a correlation between the variables. Now, this is not always adequate to establish a causal link between the two, but it is essential. And one of the ways that we can establish this correlation with our systematic observations is to construct some kind of contingency table where we look at two variables and we try to see what is the relationship between those two variables in all of the cases that we observe. Now, if we only observe the situation where a black cat crossed somebody's path and that person had a bad day that day, we don't have two variables. We're only looking at days in which the cat was present, so that's a constant, and we only look at the days where the person had a bad day. So the quality of the day is also a constant. If we want to establish a correlation between the occurrence of a black cat crossing your path and having a bad day, we've got to establish a contingency table between those two variables. So one possible outcome of those four is this: the black cat crossed the path and a bad day was the end of the day. We can also have the situation where those days where a black cat crosses the path, but the day turns out to be good. We've also got to look at all those days when no black cat crossed the path, but the day was still bad. And we've got to look at the majority of days where there was no black cat and the day was pretty good. Let's count how many days fall into each of these situations. How many days where a black cat crosses the path and the day is bad? Now, look at those days that are bad where no black cat crossed the path. That's probably more. How many days where a black cat crossed the path and the day was still pretty good? How many days where no cat crossed the path and the day was pretty good? Only by measuring each of these four possible outcomes can we really construct a contingency table and calculate the correlation that will lead to a survey providing systematic scientific evidence of the relationship between two variables.